So this is problem number 25 from Hall and Knight Higher Algebra, chapter 2. The problem is, brass is an alloy of copper and zinc. Bronze is an alloy containing 80% of copper, 4% of zinc, and 16% of tin. A fused mass of brass and bronze is found to contain 74% copper, 16% of zinc and 10% of tin. Find the ratio of copper to zinc in the composition of brass. So what we have is, we have brass and we have bronze. Okay? Now the elements that are there in brass is copper and zinc, and elements in bronze is copper, zinc and tin. So it is given that in bronze it is 80% copper, then you have 4% zinc and 16% of tin. But it is not given how much copper is there in a brass and how much zinc is there in brass. So let us say that the amount of copper in brass is some p percent, or say p fraction. Okay, we will deal with fraction here. So let us say the fraction of copper in brass is p. Then what is the composition of zinc? It should be 1 minus p. Why? Because brass is only consisting of copper and zinc. There is no tin. Right? Now let us say that we have b kilogram, or you can take any unit, b unit of brass, and z kilogram, or any other unit you want to have, of bronze. Okay, so now in b kilogram of brass, what is the weight of copper? It should be p times b. What should be the zinc? It should be 1 minus p times b. And similarly, in z kilogram of bronze, what is the weight of copper? It should be 0.8 times z. The zinc should be 0.04 times z, and tin should be 0.16 times z. Now we are given that we have b plus z kilogram of fused brass and bronze. Right? And in this we are given that it is 74% of copper, so it is 0.74 times b plus z. What is the zinc? Zinc is 0.16%. Zinc is 0.16% b plus z. And what about tin? Tin is 0.10% b plus z. Now if you see this composition of tin in the fused mass, all of this 10% is actually coming only from bronze, right? All of this 10% is coming only from bronze, because the brass does not have any tin. So what it means is, if you compare the quantity of tin, compare tin It implies that 16 by 100 Z, this weight is actually equal to 10 by 100 B plus Z. So we have 8 and 5. So from here we get 8Z is equal to 5B plus 5Z. This implies that we take B this side, so 8Z minus 5Z is 3Z is equal to 5B, and Z is to B is equal to 5 is to 3. So we know that the fused mass has been combined in the ratio 5 kilograms is to 3 kilograms. That is, we have combined, if we have 5 kilograms of bronze, we have added 3 kilograms of brass. If we have 10 kilograms of bronze, we have added 6 kilograms of brass. Okay? So now let us compare the weight of copper. So the weight of copper in brass is Pb. The weight of copper in bronze is 80 by 100 Z. Now this is equal to 74% or 74 by 100 into B plus Z, right? So from here we get PB plus 0.8 Z is equal to 0.74B plus 0.74Z. So this Z can be written as 0.74B plus 0.74 minus, that is PB is equal to 0.74B. So PB is equal to 0.74B minus 0.06Z, and therefore 0.74B minus Z can be written as 5 by 3B, so 0.06 times 5 by 3 B, and this becomes 0.02. So what we get is PB is equal to 0.74 minus 0.02 into 5 is 0.1. So this is 0.74B minus 0.10B, therefore P is equal to 0.64. So we know that brass has 64% of copper, and zinc should be 36%.